everybody. Welcome to Recharge. We're glad y'all could join us virtually tonight. We're going to do a quick prayer and then we'll go into our song. So bow your head with me. Dear Lord, thank you so much for watching over us this week. Thank you for bringing us together. Please continue to watch over us throughout the rest of this week. And just open our hearts tonight so that we can be closer to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you. well when running on empty. This week is about building your relationship with God to levels of strength you may have never experienced before.
Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to answer, what are the top three things that drain you? So we're going to start with Eric.
I think work, sitting on the couch sometimes, staying up real late. For me, it is school, sports, and my parents.
For me, it's no sleep, not doing it on something you love, and when someone has an attitude at you.
For me, it's school, having a super busy schedule, and trying my hardest to please people.
Mine is school, cheer, and working. Mine is school and cheer.
Okay, now we're going to read some verses.
Isaiah 40:31. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint.
Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a new and right spirit within me.
Philippians 3:13. Beloved, I do not consider that I have made it my own, but this one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead.
Ecclesiastes 4:10. For if they fall, no one will lift up the other. But woe to one who is alone and falls and does not have another to help.
So what is present in all of these verses?
Recharging your battery.
Okay, so we're going to talk about five things that are passion killers.
Which of these five passion killers, unhealthy people, unkind critics, unbalanced schedules, unnecessary guilt, underestimating the impact of exposure, is the one that can exhaust your fuel supply and crack and cause you to crash and burn? So unhealthy people mean that it's a person that makes you feel bad about yourself and just negative people in your life.
Unkind critics are like people that are always judging you and never trying to build you up.
Unbalanced schedule is when basically you don't have time to do stuff that you want to do and you're just out of your battery, I guess.
Unnecessary guilt is basically when you know that you may could have done something, but deep down you actually know you really couldn't have changed the outcome of something.
Underestimating the impact of exposure is like hanging out with or trying to fit in with people that you know you don't fit in with.
Has anyone experienced any of these passion killers?
Which one closely relates to you or affects you the most?
Mine would be unbalanced schedule, just because I do like multiple sports and I don't have no sleep to do stuff I want to do.
Mine would also be unbalanced schedule.
Mine would be unhealthy.
Mine's like all of them, but C. I mean, I don't really struggle with C.
I think mine's also unkind critics. So now we'll move on to the next question.
Why do people in today's world turn in order to recharge their batteries? I think most people turn to try to get more sleep or end up praying to God to help with trying to just recharge them and make them feel better.
Yeah, basically what some people will do, they'll just like pray and just slow down a little bit and meditate a little bit on things that they've done wrong.
I think like those are the healthy ways, but I think a lot of times people go out and try to
party
and just distract themselves to recharge their batteries.
Smoke weed.
But let's think about, like, if you're doing those things, you're just turning around and it's a cycle of doing those passion killers over and over again. So definitely, like, the healthy ways that JT and Trick were saying would probably be a lot better for you, a lot more beneficial. Which of the following five supply lines do you need to develop more to help keep you spiritually and emotionally fueled, and why? So I'm going to start with the first one, and that's investing in your own growth.
Yeah, so basically what I need to do is, like, just read more, read the Bible more often, and just give God the time that He needs. Because He gave us, you know, Jesus died for us, so I mean, we need to give Him that time that He gave to us.
The next one is not underestimating the power of worship. And I think for me, that's a big one. A lot of times, especially like singing in worship, I'll get really critical of myself with how I'm singing it and not thinking as much about actually just worshiping God in that moment and being present with God in that moment. The next one is unleashing the Bible into your life.
For me, I know that I probably don't read the Bible as much as I should, and unless you're basically glued to the Bible, there's always more that you can do, but I also need to work on letting it show in my life.
The next one is building great relationships.
I think it is important to build great relationships because you know you need to have a good relationship with God, and it'll make you feel better, and you have someone to talk to, and you can just understand, and it helps your life better.
And going along with what JT said, basically you need to be around people that are Christians and they do the right things.
Mm-hmm. The last one is paying attention to whose voice you're listening to.
It's making sure that you're listening to wise people and people that are good for you. That's it.
And like, it means just hanging around good people and just making good decisions in your life.
Okay, this is gonna be the last question. The question is, what is one thing you can change in your life this week to help you recharge your batteries?
I think that I could definitely, like, if I'm ever by myself with free time, instead of being on my phone, I could definitely get into the Bible.
Yeah, I agree with that. And it's also just praying more often instead of just praying, like, the day, like, in the middle or at the beginning of the day and the end of the day, just pray throughout the day.
I think for me, since I have, like, a really busy schedule, it's also being present in my relationships with the other person and making sure that I'm giving the time to them and also the time to God that's needed.
I think with my schedule, because I'm so busy, it's just not procrastinating and making my schedule work better for the time I have. I'm usually so busy, so I rush, and in that rush, I end up forgetting a lot of things and falling down a lot of things. And the first thing I usually always fall down on is my relationship with God. I forget to read the Bible, and my Bible just sits on the bookshelf, or I forget to talk to God. I forget to just do all the things I should do as a Christian.
Anybody got anything else they want to add?
All right, well, that's going to close out our discussion. We did things a little bit different this week as Molly Hirsch opened us up. Tonight's the theme was, as you probably already know, was recharging your batteries. So thank you, everyone, for coming out tonight and helping us. We will see y'all again. We're now taping on Monday nights. We will still post it online, so it'll still be on YouTube on Wednesday, so you can see it at a later date. And thank y'all so much for tuning in. We're going to close with a prayer. Dear God, thank you so much for this day, Lord. Thank you for your many blessings, Lord. Thank you for letting us come together as a youth group and just worship you, Lord. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to sit around this table and discuss things and just to dive into your word. Help this word that we've learned tonight just go with us this week. Help us to learn throughout the week to slow down, to learn to recharge with the right things so we are on the right path, Lord. We love you so much. Thank you.